that's the main goal, working together to try and meet a universal goal, which is food production and sustainable planet. I'm Abi Reader. I am a farmer from South Wales. On this farm, we produce milk for supermarket Sainsbury's. We also produce beef for them. We're a family farm, a third generation farmer, and this is where my grandfather used to work back in the 1930s. Farming is changing all the time, but as we evolve and as our animals evolve, it's about responding to the needs of the new population that has to be able to eat. Climate change is a massive issue for farmers. We're still members of the public, so we see and have the same concerns that everybody does, but we're also on the cold face of climate change. There's all sorts of things really that we need to be doing and planning, and it's just trying to evolve and use the knowledge that's out there to adapt with it. The agroforestry system we've got here is a short rotation coppice system, and it will have arable crops in between it. We will be growing this in order to produce a cash crop every 1, 2 or maybe 3 years. And there are a variety of different trees within the system. So we've got cherry, willow, aspen and lime. They're all supporting our British biodiverse habitat. And then the arable crop in between, the one that we've chosen, is an experimental crop, which is called Sida. And that will be used to hopefully grow protein, which we can feed to our livestock, particularly to our milking cows. But also we are looking at turning all of it into biochar as well, with the opportunity to help reduce ammonia emissions, to enhance the value of the slurry that we're going to be putting back on the ground, and also to try and improve the amount of organic matter that's in the soil so that our soil will become much better at holding moisture in it. If we're looking at the Sida crop that we're growing in the alleys between the agroforestry, there's a possibility there that we can reduce the amount of protein that we need to buy in. And protein is really important for producing milk, meat, and any other type of crop on the farm. So being able to build that into the system could be quite valuable and again, reduce the amount of money that we're going to have to keep paying out to bring something in that we could otherwise grow here. It's entirely different to just planting trees. This is going to provide an income. So this site here has got tree cuttings in it that are actually less than a year old at the minute. I hope that in 2 years' time, we'll see trees that are, you know, probably as tall as me, and we'll start to be looking as a viable option for a crop, something that we can actually start to develop what we want, which is the biochar, and also just to see what it looks like, how it's going to shape this landscape for the future generations. Certainly without the support of Sida Agroforestry and the Woodland Trust, I wouldn't have even gone here because I wouldn't know what I was doing, where to start or anything like that. And the result is that we've ended up with 2 hectares of land that we've put a leap of faith on, and that I've got a lot of trust in that this is going to offer benefits that could be applicable to other farms in the future. And that's the main goal, working together to try and meet a universal goal, which is food production and sustainable planet.